good, everybody? Welcome to an Epic My Damn Toys video. This shit is not for kids today, ladies and gentlemen. We are moving on to the next two figures in WWE Elite Series 73 on the brand new Elite 73, Triple H and Kairi Sane. This is our first time in the line, Kairi Sane. Lots of great accessories going on. I love this Triple H. It's probably the best one with the beard to date. It's definitely an upgrade from the Elite 60. And just actually thinking about it, guys, the fact that the Elite 60 Triple H is 13 series ago, I mean, my God, where does time go? That's ridiculous, bro. If you guys would like to pick up either of these figures, guys, go over to Ringside Collectibles. They make this review possible. You can use the promo code MDTOYS to save 10%. Plenty of WWE elites over there for cheap and a lot of other things you can get from their website. So WrestlingFigures.com, promo code MDTOYS to save some more money. And let's just shut the hell up and get into the review. Spin it to the right, guys. You have a beautiful picture of H Insane. On the back, you have the same exact image of H Insane. You have your little read-up bio thingies right here. If you'd like to read it, you can pause it now. On the side, you get a beautiful image of Triple H in green in his entrance, and then we have Kairi Sane, and that is pretty much it for the packaging, guys. So with that being said, let's go ahead and crack Triple H and Kairi Sane out of their packaging. So here's Triple H and Kairi Sane out of their packaging, guys, looking very, very nice. I will say this is definitely two strong figures. Just like Aleister Black and Daniel Bryan, both of these figures look very, very strong straight out of the packaging. Playing around with them in the hand, they feel really good. I did not take her jacket off. I wanted that to be kind of a surprise for myself, so I did not take her jacket off. We will see how that goes. It does feel like it's a softer material, though, so it should be a little bit easier to get off than former jackets that we've seen from Mattel, but that remains to be seen as we get into the accessories and things like that. So what we're going to do is take a closer look at Kairi Sane's accessories and then Kairi Sane, and then we will run it back and take a closer look at Triple H's accessories and the game. So let's go ahead and dive into this rubber jacket and find out if it's worth a damn. With Kairi Sane's accessories, guys, you actually get some pretty cool things going on, and I want to get into that immediately because this is actually pretty cool the way Mattel did this, and I did want to talk about it. So you guys know that it is a rubber jacket, which is unfortunate, but they tried something new here. It is kind of a softer material. It's not very stiff like we've seen in the past. The sleeve's kind of stiff right here, but the rest of it is pretty malleable. So right here, guys, you will see this has articulation on this arm, and what you can do is you actually pop this off, and this is how you get the jacket on her arm. It's very, very unique. I've never seen anything like that. You can literally, it pops right off, and so what you'll do is you have to take the hand out is what I would suggest. You take the hand out, you pour her arm through there just like so, and then you bend her arm back like this. You put it through the other side of the jacket, push that on through, that hand goes through, and then over here, what you would do is you take her arm like so. You'll take her arm like this, you'll push it on like this, and then you will kind of just push that on. Once you push the sleeve into the arm, her arm will raise automatically, and then that is where you would push on her hand that you would want her to have in there. So, you know, you want the salute hand or whatever have you, and then you would push that in, and bam, there you go, and then you have your salute Kairi Sane. And then to take it off, this is all you'll do. You'll pop the hand off just like so, and then you will push this arm out, and then you will remove the sleeve, and then it should slide right off like that. So they definitely made it a lot easier. That's some pretty cool technology that they have going on right there. I won't use it anyways. Like, I'm not going to be using that. I just do not like the rubber jackets, no matter how cool the, you know, the technology is. There's the Kairi Sane. But that is pretty cool that they're making strides. I think that's a very big improvement as far as the sleeves for the long sleeve jackets go. But I'm in the company where I'd rather you not make the jacket at all and include a cloth t-shirt than to make the jacket rubber and not include something cloth. I don't know. But anyways, moving on to the rest of her accessories, guys. She does come with her pirate hat, which she can fit onto her skull just like so. You just kind of stick it on there, and that fits pretty well and everything. Very nice. Go ahead and make a custom Elite Jack Sparrow. We also get the captain's wheel or the ship wheel, whatever you want to call that. So, you know, for her iconic entrance. She really doesn't do that anymore, I don't think. And then she has her beautiful telescope for, you know, hunting treasure and stuff with her, you know, the pirate princess. And then she does have her elbow, which goes on her right elbow, I do believe. And I can't remember if it goes up or down. I'm stupid. But to put on her elbow pad, guys, you will remove her hand and then slide this up the arm. And then you will put the arm back, or the hand back in. So that's very, very simple. It looks beautiful. You have the logo on there and everything like that. So Kairi Sane's elbow pad looks great. And then, of course, you have your interchangeable hands, which is the karate chop slash salute hand, and then you have her mic holding hands as the interchangeable hands. But that is pretty much it for Kairi Sane's accessories, guys. So now let's take a closer look at Kairi Sane herself. For Kairi Sane, guys, I think they did an excellent job on this head sculpt. You guys can let me know down in the comment section below. I think they nailed it. I think it definitely looks like Kairi Sane. I love the hair color that we got going on. I love that they added this little loop right here on her, or on her chest piece right there. It is removable if you wanted to remove it, but I think they definitely captured the likeness of Sane. I like the braids they got going through the hair and everything like that. The white attire looks absolutely perfect. I love the red streak going down. Very nice attire. White bicep bands going down. I think we've seen the, have we seen this crotch piece before? I can't remember if we've seen that little belt sculpted on there. Nonetheless, it looks really good. You have Kairi there, Sane on the other butt cheek. Her elbow pad looks good. I think the wrist gauntlets and everything look great. I like the newly sculpted hands right here. Seems like they did some skin tone over the, I think they sculpted her to have gloved hands, but they did paint it in skin tone. Not a big deal. She does have her nail polish going on. Down into the knees, we do get double jointed knees with this figure, which is absolutely fantastic freaking farticles. We have her beautiful knee pads with the boat wheel and the anchor there, looking great. I love her kick pads. I think the white with the stripes and everything is so clean. It kind of looks like she's wearing like loafers or like slippers or Vans or something. I think that looks great and everything like that. No ankle pivot, but I still think the figure feels good, looks good in the hand. It's just a strong figure, man. I think the women's figures are taking more upgrades. Like we saw with the Elite 72 Becky Lynch, this Kairi Sane is very nice in the collection. I'm very happy to have this. I think she's a fantastic talent, and you know, the ab crunch is all good and like that. You get some good diaphragm movement, and all the joints are tight. You know, you ain't got to worry about any loose joints or anything. Very, very strong Kairi Sane figure, man. I think this is definitely going to rank high when we get into our, you know, worst to best ranking system. But that pretty much does it for our Kairi Sane Elite 73 figure. Getting into some Kairi Sane Elite figure comparisons, guys, since we do not have another Kairi Sane figure to compare her to, we have her Kabuki Warrior, terrible tag team name, tag team partner Asuka to compare her to, and they look really good up next to each other. I hate they don't really have similar attire or anything, but I think that we can get away with it. I think they look great next to each other. I think they scale well and everything. Asuka sitting a little bit taller and everything like that, but I like both of these a lot. This is, of course, the Target exclusive NXT. It is the Target exclusive network spotlight Asuka figure, and one thing I will say is this Asuka is very loose at the diaphragm joint, but the Kairi Sane feels really good, dude. Like, this figure is fantastic. The Elite 73 Kairi Sane is, again, dude, when we rank them, it's going to be really official, but that pretty much does it for our Kairi Sane Elite figure comparisons. Now, with Triple H's accessories, guys, you do get a decent amount of stuff. You will see here, we do get his black vest. I think this is from his WrestleMania 35 match with Batista, so we do have both figures from that match, which is pretty epic. We get the NXT logo here. I think this is pretty much the exact same molded leather vest that we got with his Elite 60 figure. I will be comparing them when we get the Elite 60 figure down for the Elite comparison, but spinning it around, you get the Tyrannus Imperium on the back. You have a great Triple H skull logo with the, you know, the Iron Cross with the sledgehammers and everything going on. Very iconic for Triple H. So beautiful. Such epicness. One of my favorites of all time. Just such a goat, man. He's so beautiful. You get the beautiful zipper and button details going on. Would it be nice to be cloth? Yes, but I think I can stick with this. I think that with, you know, vests and stuff, I think rubber is okay, but it's when you get into the long jackets and stuff that it's just like, give me the figure in cloth or give me the accessory in cloth or I don't want it. You also get this beautiful hood, but, you know, it's the same deal that we've seen with AJ in the past where you just kind of sit this in there. I don't think it ports in. It just kind of sits down in there and then, you know, it kind of hugs and that is how it's supposed to be, but I don't use it anyway, so I probably won't even, you know, I won't even use this thing, but I think you just kind of set it behind the head right there and it stays in there. I'm not sure, but you also get this face guard, and I don't think the face guard can go on unless you have that hoodie on there, so we're going to test it right now to see if it will hug onto the figure. So I guess, yeah, it does actually hug on. So it does hug on, and it, yeah, it'll stay if you just set it on there. It is a rubbery plastic, though. It's like rubber, so it will, like, it's not hard or anything. It is malleable, so you just kind of stick it on there and it will hug. So that is very nice to see with the, you know, the skull face guard. Not only that, you do get a beautiful water bottle that we always get with Triple H, because, you know, it's Triple H, man. It's time to play the game. One of the most iconic entrances of all time. Would not be Triple H without the signature water bottle. And then we have a pair of interchangeable fists, and on the figure out of the packaging, you get mic holding hands in the left hand and then a choke slamming hand in the right hand, but they've been doing that with every Triple H Elite since he's come out, I think. But that pretty much does it for H's accessories, guys. So now let's take a closer look at the game himself. So taking a closer look at Triple H, guys, this head sculpt is phenomenal. I think it's definitely the best Triple H head sculpt that we've seen with the true effects and the beard and everything. It looks really strong, man. I really do enjoy it. I think it looks like him. One thing I will say is maybe a little gray in the beard or something like we saw with Ciampa, or something like that, but I think that it's undeniable. I think it looks great. I really think it's terrific. We are going to compare it to the Elite 60 head sculpt in the next segment of the video, but I still think that it is great. I really do like it and everything like that. I think the likeness is uncanny. Going down, we have the same Triple H torso we've seen 852 times. Same shoulders, same arms. Elbow pads do have the iron crosses on it. Little chippy there. Sort of sucks. Usually, or Triple H figures usually have like a problem with loose waist. This one actually does not suffer from that problem, so that's very nice to see. This is definitely an upgrade from the Elite 60 already. Going down, we covered that it does have all these great logos on the trunks. On the back, you have the signature HHH, which I really like, and the black and white negative spacing right there looks very fantastic. White tapes on the hands because it's Triple H. Going down here, this is something unique that he started doing in the later part of his career. He wore the white knee tape, the black calf sleeves, and then he would have knee pads over that with his black boots that have the skulls on it, and I think these are the exact boots, or if they're not the exact boots that we saw with the Elite 60, they are very, very close. But Triple H figures, man, I mean, they're pretty simple. They're like, you know, the short tights, the elbow pads, the tape, the black boots, and then a cool head sculpt with some cool accessories. I mean, that's usually what happens. It'll come with a water bottle or a sledgehammer, and that, I mean, that's pretty much it. It's a beautiful looking figure, but nothing too crazy, man. So getting into some Elite Triple H figure comparisons, guys, you will see we have the brand new Elite 73 in the middle, followed by the Elite 60 on the left. I know that the head is not correct. It's because I head swapped my Elite 60 and my Battle Pack with Daniel Bryan head sculpt. And you guys can see that these two are pretty much identical. I mean, I don't know how you could tell any differences. Maybe a little bit better True Effects on the left one, or they pretty much, I guess, maybe this one didn't have True Effects just yet. Maybe this one is the first one with the True Effects. But nonetheless, it's pretty much the same one. And I think this one does have a little bit better detail. And another thing I do want to point out between the Elite 73 and the Elite 60 is, again, that loose waist is fixed. They actually fixed that, so that is much better. I appreciate that. And you guys can see how similar these two figures are. I would say that the Elite 73 is a little bit more superior given the loose waist joint and the, I don't know, I like this Trunks logo better. And then on the back, I like this logo better because it's pretty much the same exact logo on the front and back. And then the boots, again, are pretty much identical as well. And then you just get the black calves that he wore against Batista. But that pretty much does it for our Triple H Elite figure comparisons. But I think that about does it for this 2-in-1 Elite 73 review on the brand new Elite Series 73 Triple H and Kairi Sane figures. Guys, I would highly recommend both of them. I think that this Triple H is an upgrade from the Elite 60. So if you guys missed out on the Elite 60, I think that figure actually runs pretty high in price nowadays because of the bearded, bald, you know, Triple H head sculpt that is kind of rare. But now with the new release of the Elite 73, hopefully that price will drop and the Elite 73 should be much easier to find, hopefully, and that will take that price much down, and again, it'll be a lot better. I'm just now realizing that Kairi Sane is 5'1", which is absolutely crazy, which explains this massive height difference between the two, but both figures are great. I love the pirate hat. It actually fits Triple H over here, so that's looking pretty nasty. If you would like to pick up either of these figures, guys, you can go over to ringsidecollectibles.com using the promo code MDTOYS, and you can get in on all their Black Friday deals going on starting today at 6 p.m. Eastern, and I am posting all three Elite Series 73 reviews, so definitely go check out Aleister Black and Daniel Bryan, and as well as Grand Metalik and Elias's review. I'm posting all three of them together because why not, guys? Put them all three up. You guys can enjoy all three of them, whichever reviews you want to watch. I would appreciate it if you watched all three of them, but that is what it is. But thank you guys so very much. Again, I would recommend both of them. I appreciate you guys so very much. Have a happy Thanksgiving again. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE, epic WWE stuff videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.